respected president of IMA Kodapakkam branch, secretary of Arunachal and the dynamic secretary, Professor Chandrasekhar, Professor Padma Chandrasekhar, Dr. Mani and others. Yes, indeed. I totally agree with what Arunachalam said, but only thing, the word black history was not used at all. Because for any government program, we are supposed to uphold for it. The auditors will object to it. Daily, there is a reason why you want to do this thing. Okay, now, my talk will be more interactive because the time consists only 20 minutes given to me, so I'll try to cut short my talk. And let me be more interactive. Now, where was this dots born? If you make it fast, you can extend my time also. Where was the dots born? Vimal? Chennai DRC. Okay. Who can be a dot provider? Anybody except a family member, but again there is an exception where the mother can be the dot provider for a pediatric participation. Now I will be talking about the two portions of my talk. One is on the international standard of tuberculosis care. The other one, what are the schemes available for practitioners under this particular. Before I proceed, let me just mention about the alphabets which are there in the banner there. Indian Medical Association, Global Fund to Fight AIDS, Tuberculosis and Malaria, Revised National Tuberculosis Control Program, Public-Private Mix, Rolling Continuation Channel Project. The two reasons why we all met here is one for the PPM and the other one is emergence of the multi-resistant tuberculosis. The CTD and the Government of India at last realized the importance of practitioners. So any program cannot be successful without including practitioners, and this is the reason why IMA has been accepted the largest NGO and this particular project has come here. So every year we have to do a branch CME and a district training program. Now let me talk about the International Standard Tuberculosis Care. Now, the partners for this are the Center for Disease Control, the American Coast Nursing and the World Health Organization being funded by USAID. Now what is this? How is this IC different? It focuses on care as well as control and has got an evidence base and it appeals all the practitioners. Now I will talk about 17 standards, 6 for diagnosis, 9 for treatment and 2 for public responsibilities. Now all providers who undertake evaluation treatment of pregnant tuberculosis and recognize that not only are they delivering care to an individual, but they are also assuming an important public health function. These providers are, sorry, who are these providers you are talking about? You and I, we are the providers you are talking about. Not all patient respiratory symptoms receive an adequate evaluation of tuberculosis. These failures lead to increased disease severity for the patients and a greater likelihood of transmitting tuberculosis to family members. It only says that in our busy practice, let us concentrate a little more on the patients who come with respiratory symptoms so they are liable to visit tuberculosis patients. Now, how many weeks of cough was taken earlier to rule out diarrhea tuberculosis? Earlier, how many weeks, sir?
4 weeks.
3. Now? 2 weeks. So, in other words, the patient was coming for 3 days, now he's coming for 2 days. Can we reduce it to 1 day? Any chance? Is it possible to reduce it to 1 day or not? It is possible. Provided the awareness is created among the society and the people, the patient can walk in this early morning sputum and give the spot when he meets the doctor, same day diagnosis and same day treatment as per the vision of a present health secretary. Now, the repeated sputum samples are being done, although you have found that the sputum is positive, it's only to know the progress of the disease, whether it's responding and whether it's going for any resistance, etc. And we'll go to the detail. This is only a sensitization program. When you go for the training program, we'll go to the depth of the subject, where you have to do the sputum, when you have to do, why you have to do, and all these things. Now, here comes the evidence base. Of course, Professor KVT has just left. And if you ask him, we are all treating earlier more empirically based on the clinical knowledge and the clinical findings. But here our first tuberculosis has more evidence base. What are the types of tuberculosis we are discussing about? We know those talking about tuberculosis. One, we have the pulmonary tuberculosis, the other is the extra pulmonary tuberculosis. In pulmonary, we have sputum positive and sputum negative. The evidence base for sputum positive is sputum positivity. The evidence base for sputum negative is initially you do the sputum positivity. If it is negative, you put him an antibiotic. As he has mentioned, try to avoid fluoroquinolones. Then again, you test for sputum. If it is again negative, then go for the X-ray. So X-ray is going to change, then it's going to smear negative pulmonary tuberculosis. So that is the evidence base. Then as far as extra pulmonary tuberculosis is concerned, as it's already mentioned, you can go for an FNAC for a glandular tuberculosis, or you can go for culture, or you can go for X-ray findings. So definitely it is more evidence based. And the last word there says that once you have gone for evidence base, still you are not able to tap the evidence, you are the final judge. you still feel it's tuberculosis, kindly start him on the treatment. Now, as you saw, he has covered half of my topic. Vinod has covered half of my topic. Why X-ray is not used as a primary tool of diagnosis is for these simple reasons. Due to high inter-reader variation. What is inter-reader variation, sir? Anybody? Same X-ray, by 10 different people interpret it 10 different ways. Intra-reader variation, same person, same X-ray, different times, different diagnosis. So for these reasons, as well as no shot typical and 10 different cancer of post undiagnosed, X-ray is used as a complementary tool in diagnosis of tuberculosis. Now, he has already mentioned about Mantoux test. So we just, this slide only says that we cannot treat an adult tuberculosis based only on a Mantoux test. It only says he's been infected, but it's not preserved the disease stage, whereas it's got primary importance as for pediatric tuberculosis concern. Now let's go over standards for treatment. Now in this slide, treatment for tuberculosis is not only a matter of individual health, it's also a matter of public health. All providers must have the knowledge to prescribe a standard treatment regimen and the means to assess adherence to ensure the treatment is completed. There are only two phrases in the entire slide which is important, around which the entire R&DCP program is wound around. These are the two phrases. The first phrase is, what is this? Standard treatment regimen. For example, a 5-year-old or a 75-year-old get the same treatment, man or woman same treatment, Hindu, Christian, Muslim, who it may be, this treatment has been standardized in R&DCP. Whereas the other side, when you look at the other side, people use their own different systems and their own different regimens. Some use AKT4, some use AKT3, some even use AK47 on a later day. The other one is adherence. How is this adherence adhered to an R&DCP? Anybody? How is a patient treatment assessing the adherence adhered? Through dots, directly observed treatment. Whereas this adherence is not adhered to in the other setup. Whereas once you write a prescription, the patient stops the medicine, the moment symptoms are all right, then he comes back to you faithfully after 1 month. As a counselor, you write there, he comes back, but you don't know whether he's taking it or not. Thereby giving rise to resistant tuberculosis. Fine. So he's already mentioned that the responsibility has been shifted from patient health system. We belong to the health system. We put on side it is T1, T2, etc., etc. We come out of the last one as a private practitioner. Now this only mentions about the 4 drugs, isoniazid, difenbenzamide, which are used for a simple primary, simple positive case, 2 months of intensive phase, 4 months of continuation phase, etc., etc., etc. Now as a doc provider, when the patient accepts you as a dot provider, somebody else has to accept us as a dot provider. I think this word, PPM, gives a clue. So who should be the other person accepting you as a dot provider? I am a dot provider for my patient, he accepts me. Who else has to accept me as a dot provider? The public, private, which is the public mind in this audience right now for this talk? The DTO or the Deputy Director of Medical Services at Tuberculosis, or the medical officer there. So they have to accept you as a dot provider, apart from the patient accepting you as that. So the dot provider who is acceptable to accept patient and accountable to the health system. Now let me tell you, how many of us insist on our patients to get back the records when they come to us after seeing several doctors in our own practice? Do we or we do not ask? Excellent, excellent, excellent. Why do you ask for it? Any reason?
One
drug
is already taken.
Very good.
Why not?
Good. Next.
Whether he has been managed properly.
Very good. Anything else?
Completed the course.
Good. All your answers are accepted, sir, but there is something sitting on the neck of each one of us today. What is that?
Preserving the record.
Excellent. In other words, the consumer protection is sitting on the neck of each one of us. For every case in a consumer court, there's one doctor behind that case, agree or not?
Yes.
Dr. Arunachal is treating one of his patients who got headache for the past 20 years. A mere faith. He treats him, patient becomes only goes away. When Arunachal was out of station, Dr. Mani treats the same patient. Immediately Mani, sorry sir, not
please, please, please.
Immediately Dr. Mani says, enna ithna thadalo x-ray kuda irukke illaya varala. Or CT scan panilo or MRI panilo. Next day that flows the consumer. Now I am going to make a statement now. In the consumer court, the onus is on the patient to prove that the doctor is negligent. It is not for the doctor to prove that it is not negligent. What does it mean? It is a record, as Dr. Mani has mentioned, the record of the doctor is going to bail him out of the consumer act. So this is as for the practice concerned. So tomorrow from onwards, let us mention something relevant to the patient in our own prescriptions, whereas outpatient or inpatient will have real good records. Now why should you have records for R&Ts which is there for so many years? Where is the need for records? What is prior to R&TCP, sir? NTP. So from NTP to R&TCP, only based on the records. Now there are several government programs, but I can assure you the R&T has got an excellent recording system. When the patient goes for investigation, separate draft card is open. When he goes for treatment, separate treatment card is open. So the excellent recording system as far as the R&TCP is concerned. This is the lab card, the treatment card, etc., etc., etc. Now there are two diseases of modified tuberculosis in the present arena. One is the communicable, the other non. What are the two diseases, sir? HIV and diabetes. Okay, now what is this ICTC? Anybody? Integrated Counseling and Testing Center. When Dr. Mani is treating a tuberculosis patient, he is suspecting HIV, he refers to the HIV clinic. When Dr. Arunachal is going to treat the HIV patient, he suspects tuberculosis is going to. So there is cross reference. So there is known as ICTC, both always all under the same roof generally. Now once a patient, a tuberculosis patient suspects HIV, he is referred to the HIV clinic. His report comes as HIV positive. Do we start the patient immediately on ART or should we do something else?
So we should start.
Right. That is the present thing. But earlier, once a patient has HIV positive, in fact, what is the cause of disease in a patient with tuberculosis and HIV?
Immunocompromised.
What is the cause of death in a patient who has got tuberculosis and HIV?
Tuberculosis.
HIV per se does not kill a person. With the beautiful ART drugs and wonderful nutrition, it does not kill. It's only the opportunity to give most of the tuberculosis. So here, as far as concerned, once a patient got a type of tuberculosis, continue to be with the tuberculosis and put him on cold time also, so we take care of the opportunity infection. And once the CD4 count comes, then we start him on ART. But as Mani has mentioned, definitely today it has changed. Even with HIV positive, straight away now ART is being started for the patients. So the last line is, cold trimoxazole prophylactic therapy. How long is given? CPT. Lifelong. Okay. Is MDR a clinical diagnosis or a lab diagnosis? It's a lab diagnosis. And where is it done? In all laboratories or any specific labs? Only two labs in Tamil Nadu. One is TRC Checkpoint, Intimate Reference Laboratory, and another is CMC. Now, I will say one thing now. A is a simple sputum positive pulmonary tuberculosis patient. B is a multi-drug resistant tuberculosis patient. Again, I repeat, A is simple sputum positive, B is multi-drug. Can somebody tell me the reasons between the duration of treatment, the cost of treatment, anything A and B? What's the duration of treatment in A?
2+4, 6 years.
24 to 27 months. Cost here? About 3,000, here about 3 lakhs. Here, handful of medicine, bagful of medicines. Oral medicines, injectable medicines. Domicile treatment, hospitalization treatment. Agree? With all these things, what's the net result? Do you think everybody is going to stress this response? Certainly not. So definitely it's a duty to prevent the emergence of MDR tuberculosis. Now once the patient diagnoses tuberculosis, when do you start your treatment? Same day, next day, or what do you do before starting your treatment?
Same day.
Fine, excellent. Same day or at the most by next day. Do you do something before you start your treatment? Should we do something before you start your treatment? Today when you say he has got diabetes, does he accept immediately?
Education.
Excellent. Money is on the dot. You have to counsel the patient. He says, I always go to 5-star hotel, sir. My family will not be tuberculosis. First is denial, you will not accept. So counsel the patient and family members. Second, you have to do screening of the family members, especially children below 6 years. And thirdly, you have to check his address. Why address, sir? What is the need for checking the address of the patient? Yeah, why? What is surrounding? What does it mean? We are under DOTS therapy, directly observed treatment. This is the difference between, I told you in the beginning itself, adherence. So the patient does not come to you, we are supposed to retrieve you the very next day. So that is why definitely these three things should be done before you start the on treatment. What happened? Sorry. Fine. Now, as per the I said, we normally say that sputum has to be done only in a DMCA, designated medical center, because the technician claimed R&D secret. The slide seen with R&D to technician is always viewed by the higher ups. Supposing 10 slides are reviewed by the higher up and 3 are found false positive, what is the implication? 3 slides are false positive slides, what do you think is the implication? Unnecessary treatment, unnecessary stigmatization, waste of money, etc. Suppose the 3 false negative slides, what is the implication? It's going to spread, spread. So these are all as far as R&D is there. Now, is tuberculosis a notifiable disease or not?
Yes.
Since when?
Since
ages. Since ages, at least in Tamil Nadu, but you will not be bothered at all. Now, IMS has taken the lead. On 22nd April, at the Central Council meeting, IMS has taken a decision that in confirmed requirement international for tuberculosis, IMS decides to notify TB patient nation for its mandatory. No more options. Secondly, I may also recommend practitioners to follow the ISTC, about which I have been talking right now, they are diagnosed micro TB patients. Now, you have noted the date here, okay, 22nd April. Now, note this date, sir. Which is early, which is late? IMA has come forward to protect our IMA members, and they have come forward before notifying, even before the government of India has come forward. So, there is a notification, and it only defines. We come under the last rung as individual practitioners. Whether allopathy practitioner, ayurvedic practitioner, unani practitioner are supposed to notify the TB disease. In fact, the point is extended past the pharmacy also to notify. When a patient goes to buy tuberculosis medicines, the pharmacy has to notify their patients on this thing. Now, let us look at the patient charter for tuberculosis care. What are the patient's rights? He's got the right to care and right to dignity and information choice as per contract and justice and order. What do you think is important in all these things? Do you think everything is important? Should we remove one or two from this? Patient's rights. Shall we give all the rights to him?
Yes, sir.
If so, which is more important?
Confidential.
Correct, sir?
Confidential.
Anything else?
Right. Care.
Anything else? Till I get the answer, I say anything else, anything else. Sir. Anything else?
This one.
He is a human being, I am a human being, sir. We can quote any number of doctors who can see 3 to 4 people in the same room, the same time, the same. Do you think he's going to divulge the information? In benefit, I've been seen. Repeatedly, we've been going there. Injection, they start giving instructions, etc. So, kindly maintain the dignity of the patient. Whatever outpatient clinic you have, kindly bring the patient separately and use it. Everything else follows automatically. Now, what is his responsibility? Share information. Who is to share information with whom? Patient to doctor to patient, doctor to relation to doctor, whom?
All.
Primary, which is more important? Who has to share information with whom?
Patient to doctor.
Excellent. Patient to the doctor. In the first slide itself, I said you spend more time when patients got respiratory symptoms. So, when you are going to spend more time with him, you have to develop a rapport with him. After 5 minutes, you start telling, 6 months back, I went to Dr. Mani, sir, he gave me treatment. After 3 days of fever subside, I stopped the medicine. In another 5 minutes, Kaichi, he said, 1 year back, I went to Arunachal. Another 5 minutes, I went to Professor Chandrasekhar, 2007, to Pune, sir. Why do you think you have to spend this time and ask this information? Okay? Right?
Resistance.
You have to categorize a patient. Only from the history you know whether it's treatment. If it is good to Gudra water Madri, you will also be treating him on a new patient scheme, thereby giving resistance to rise to resistance to tuberculosis. Right. Okay. Now, so R&D is confirmed almost all the standards for Iger Street Public Health. Best way to practice TB care is considered. Now the next portion of mine is to talk about the schemes available to the practitioners. See, now let me take, I'll have to take somebody as an example. Now let me once again take Dr. Mani. Mani is seeing a patient suspecting tuberculosis. He is referred to the DMC for sputum examination. Sputum is positive. The patient comes back. The private man is making use of the public facility. That's what the PPM. The private practitioner is getting all the benefits from the public facility. When he refers a patient to the DMC, the Designated Medical Center, once it is positive, Dr. Vinod Kumar, who is a medical officer, sends back the patient to you with the patient voice box. The patient voice box gives two information. One, it says the entire course is there. Two, it says there's no death of medicines. Today in outpatient GH or anywhere, they keep changing the drugs. One day sulfonylurea, next a bicarbonate, hypertension, metabolic. But here, if it doesn't take, the fault is either with you or in the patient. So the entire course is given, the 6 months course is given in the box. So the patient does not spend for your treatment. So entire thing is given free. And at the end of 6 months, you get a granting aid of 250 rupees. So you become a dot provider, your clinic becomes a dot center, your practice is going to improve by way of your patient going to be ambassador, and you're going to get a granting aid. So this is one scheme known as treatment adherence scheme. The other scheme is the sputum collection and sputum transfer. You need not send your patient to the government lab at all. You can have the cups in your own clinic provided by the D2Os. You can give the sputum there, refer him to the laboratory, there ends the problem. 3, you can refer the patient. 4, designated microscopy center. It's only a name given to the lab where the technician is trained by the R&D center. Today, one DMC is granted for 1 lakh population, the government center. Having got this project, this DFATM project, DMC is granted in private setup also, provided to satisfy 6 criteria. First, you must have 60 to 100 outpatients per day, 3 to 4 samples of sputum per day, trained medical officer, that is you, after undergoing the training. Your technician is trained with RNTCP for no cost. You must have a place to set up the lab, and 6, you must have a binocular microscope. If you satisfy the 6 criteria, you can apply for a DMC and it is granted after due inspection. But why at all you want a DMC in a private sector? Do you require it? Where is the need? Do you require it or don't require a DMC in a private sector?
You require.
Reason. Straight away patient asks on your face, sir, unga clinic na vandirukken enak theriyada OT report nu ketta. I came to as a private clinic, why you are referring me there? So he is going to be with you only till the end of the treatment. 2, the government DMC closes at 2 o'clock or 3 o'clock. He comes back only at 5 o'clock or 6 o'clock or 7 o'clock. So for accessibility and time, etc., definitely require private DMCs. So these are all, I'll just run through the slides, my talk is over. So the training was for 4 hours. Such of those who are interested in training can always give your names to the transcription secretary. So 250 is given for you at the end of 6 months, and another 150 is for retrieval. If you are able to retrieve your patient, you get another 150. So this is eligibility for the private DMCs. And once a DMC is granted, you have to take part in what is known as EQA, External Quality Assurance. That's what the false positive, false negative, etc. Just like that, they won't grant you a DMC. You are answerable to the higher authority. Thank you for the opportunity given. We are ready to take any questions.